One way to make your data visually more appealing to your users is by using charts. So let's have a look how to add amazing charts to your .NET MAUI application. Now, this charting library that we're going to talk about in this video, the Microcharts, is one that you might already know from your Xamarin Forms days, which is really amazing because it was a great library back then and it's still a great library now. It's very simple to use. You can just drop in your data, choose which type of chart you want to show, and then boom, it looks visually amazing. It has some animations whenever it's coming up. So there is a lot to uncover. And the great thing is there is now a version that supports .NET MAUI, and I think the APIs are just literally the same. So you can just take your code whenever you're migrating from Xamarin Forms, take your code and put that in your .NET MAUI application, install the right package, and it will just work as it did before. So that's really cool. Now, let's just have a look. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just created a file new .NET MAUI project, which you can see right here. It's still the default template. I've named it MAUI Microchart Sample. That's also the name of the GitHub repository that's on my account. You can find the link in the video description below. If you want to review the code, it's all there. Now, before I am going to change things in this XAML, I'm going to show you how to install the NuGet package. Well, actually how to find it. I already installed it. So if you go over to the Solution Explorer, we can right click on the project and you can do manage NuGet packages. And we can browse and search for Microcharts. Now there's an interesting thing I already mentioned, like this also has some history with Xamarin and Xamarin Forms. So you're going to find this one by Alois Daniel. I hope I pronounced this correctly, and Ed Lomonaco. So they have been maintaining this for a long, long time in the Xamarin days, the good old days, and they have a lots of downloads, right? And it's version 0.9.5.9. That's not the one that you need. That one is not maintained anymore, as far as I know. So the people who are behind this MAUI version have taken that code, built upon that, made it compatible with MAUI, and hopefully they're going to now maintain that for, you know, some time to come. The one that you want to have is .MAUI. And I think if you go over to the repository, then you can see that it also supports all kinds of other cool things. So you can use it with without MAUI. So just the .NET for iOS and .NET Android. You can use it for Uno, for Avalonia. So for all these kinds of things. And that's because this is based on Skia Sharp. So you will see that it also brings in some Skia Sharp dependencies right here. And Skia Sharp is a drawing library that's crazy fast, crazy cool. You can do a lot of amazing things with that. And that's what makes these charts so powerful and great looking, right? If you don't know what Skia Sharp is, let me know down in the comments, but don't worry about it, right? It will just make these charts work. So that's really cool. I installed it already. We've done that. And the next thing that you want to do to bootstrap this plugin is then go over to your Solution Explorer, go to your mauiprogram.cs, and you want to add this use microcharts. That wires up all the things that are needed for this library, for this package, and you will be good to go. Make sure that it imports this using right here, using microcharts.maui, and that's all. Good. Okay, so with this in place, now we can finally start building our charts. Now, the way this works, this is working with Skia Sharp, so it works with drawing on the screen. To do that, we need a canvas. And the way that's implemented is with a chart view. So I'm going to remove all of this from the default template. And we actually have to import this XML namespace right here. So let's do XML and S micro. I'm just going to call it micro. Is, and then you can do with IntelliSense, you can look for micro charts and you want to have this .MAUI one. So that's the one. This is the full line that you want to have. This micro can be anything. This is just a short name where you can find all the controls, all the objects under that are in this namespace right here. So let's go to micro and you can already see that it only has one thing. It has chart view, right? So that it has some properties, which is not really things that you want to use because it works a little bit differently than you maybe expected to work, right? The one thing that you might find interesting is chart, which enables you to also use this with MPVM. I'll come back to that in a little bit, but that's the one that you might find interesting to actually use. I'm going to make this an X name, so I'm going to give this a name field, chart view, so that I can reference it from my code behind. Now, this is basically your canvas that you're going to work with to draw the actual chart on. So here we can actually give this some height request and width request that might be interesting as well. I'm just going to leave it as it is for now. And then here in my mainpage.xaml.cs, I already prepared some entries. So this chart entry, that's an object that is built into this microcharts library. You can see it does using microcharts and using Skia Sharp as well. And we have these chart entries, and that's our data points, right? So that is the abstract version, the object that holds our data that can be plotted on any type of chart, right? Because we have a couple of different charts that we can use here. So I have some dummy data here. You can specify the value, you can specify a value label if that's different from the actual value. You can have this windows label right here, and you can specify it with a color, right? And this is a Skia Sharp color dot parse, and you can just parse it from some hex value here. So I got a couple of entries lined up here. You can have that in different formats. You can pull that down from an API if that's what you want, which is probably more typical, but I just have a couple of hard-coded things here. And then in our main page, I can here do chart view dot chart is new. And now we can go to whichever type of chart we want to have. So we can say bar chart, right? We can say donut chart, donuts, right? You can have line charts. So you have all these different kinds of things. Let's go with a bar chart first, nice and sweet. And for each chart, then you have a different set of properties. There are definitely a common set of properties as well. So I don't know, you have like a background color, obviously. What else do we have? Like a bar area alpha. If you can want to animate whenever it showed yes or no, so is animated. The label color, the legend option, so you can show the legends yes or no. You can have series. So there is a ton of options here. If there's anything that you want to learn that I'm not covering in this video, because this is just the getting started video, let me know down in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe so you'll be notified when that new video comes right at you. All right, so we have all this stuff, but the only thing I'm going to use now is entries, right? So I'm just going to assign these entries with this entries variable that I got set up in the top here. And now it's all set up to show me these entries. I'm going to have to remove the boilerplate code here that's from the default template because it references elements that are not there anymore. So let's just do that so that the code sample is nice and cleaned up, and I can just start running this on Windows. So I'm just going to run this on my Windows machine that deploys the fastest, and then it's going to show you this magnificent bar chart with the different options here. I should see, what is it, 1, 2, 3, 4 options, each with a different value showing up in a bar. By default, it's animated. I'm not really sure if that's going to show up on the recording real nice because I have this complicated setup. It doesn't really show you that great, I think. But here we have this bar chart. Just like that, a couple of lines of code, an amazing looking bar chart. Now I can, of course, this is like full screen, right? So I can obviously also implement this somewhere in my layout. So I can just say, hey, I can wrap this in, I don't know, a vertical stack layout. And then I can stack a couple under each other, right? So I can just do this. And then I can maybe do another one and do chart view 1. And I can specify here like the height request with like, I don't know, 200. And also do a height request of 200 here as well. And now I should have two charts on top of each other. Well, I'm going to assign something here. So let's make this a different type. So I'm going to make this that donut chart. Donut chart. And now if I run this again on Windows, we're going to see a bar chart and a donut chart on top of each other. But the main thing that I want to show you here as well is like, hey, you can put this in any element in your layout, right? So you can just have this grid with all kinds of other stuff around it, and you can just show these different bar charts here. So it doesn't really come out that great. Maybe if I make this height request like 500, maybe I should, oh, there we go. So this is better. And I should probably wrap it in a scroll view now because it goes out of the viewport. But you can see that we have this bar chart at the top with all the labels and things there. But we also have this donut chart here at the bottom with all the legends and all the values there as well. And then we have, of course, like, let's make this chart view 1. Let's make it something different. And let's make this a line chart, which looks really great too. So we have that one just to show you the couple of options. And obviously, if you're going to run this on iOS or Android, then it's going to show up the same way. That's one of the powers, the superpowers of Skia Sharp as well, because this is drawn, it's going to look the exact same on each of the platforms here as well. And I think I should probably now make this 500 as well, because the line looks really flat now. Well, and now it falls off the screen, right? So I shouldn't improvise here. I prepared something else, and that's why it's not going here. So here you can see this line chart, and now we have this nice wave of things and different values, right? So that's all that's going on here. Now, I will wrap up this sample. I will make a little scroll view around this and make sure that it goes nicely on the GitHub page, and then you know how to get started with these great charts in .NET MAUI.
Donut chart. Oh, sorry. I was still wondering about the donuts.
So this is such an amazing library. It makes it super easy, just a couple of lines of code to create amazing looking charts inside of your .NET MAUI app. And the really cool thing is this doesn't just work for .NET MAUI. It also works for .NET for iOS, .NET for Android, and the API is the exact same as it was with Xamarin Forms. So it should be super easy to migrate your Xamarin Forms project to .NET MAUI and still have this great library at your disposal. You can just go to the GitHub repository for this library, Microcharts. You can find the link down below. Make sure to start that repository, check out all the samples there, and of course, let me know in the comments if you want to see more follow-up videos about this. See you for the next one.